Okay, shall we start? Thank you very much for coming, audience members. We're very happy to have you. So this is just a little book talk about some books in Russian, German, and Spanish that are connected to the Christmas season. So, and we have lots of books in English in this library, and we have a few books in other languages for students who are doing reading. So we'd like to start with Monika Sugimoto, who's from the German department, and she will talk about some books in German.
Yes, that's true. Welcome. I would like to introduce three books, and I would like to do this in English and German, if it's okay for you. Also, ich spreche Englisch und Deutsch. Ich hoffe, Sie verstehen mich. So first of all, here's a children's book for children who can read for themselves, or can also the parents can read the book for them. This is the German original and the Japanese translation. Ein Kinderbuch zum Vorlesen oder zum Selberlesen mit japanischer Übersetzung. And second, I have also a Christmas book. This is maybe not for kids, but for adults. It's not explicit, but it's maybe if kids will read it, they won't enjoy it. Das ist für Erwachsene. Es ist nicht so lustig für Kinder. And third, here's a picture book, ein Bilderbuch. And I would like to start with this story. So this guy here is called Nikolaus. Er heißt Nikolaus. And he will visit the kids in Germany to bring them presents, chocolate and apples and nuts and things they enjoy. Er bringt für die Kinder Nüsse und Äpfel und kleine Geschenke, Schokolade. And he's not coming alone, so let me show you this. So he's always with his scary friend. Er kommt nicht alleine, er hat immer einen Freund dabei. And this scary friend, you can see him here, his name is Knecht Ruprecht. He's called Knecht Ruprecht. And he is called Nikolaus. You can see this here. So in this story he's visiting kids in a village. Er besucht Kinder in einem kleinen Dorf, and there's a lot of snow in the forest, and Nikolaus and Knecht Ruprecht cannot find their way. And I have a quiz for you. Sie suchen ihren Weg zu den Kindern, und ich habe eine Frage für euch. On what day are the kids visiting, Nikolaus and Knecht Ruprecht visiting the children? An welchem Tag kommen die beiden? Is it December 6 or December 12 or December 24? Am 6., am 12. oder am 24. Dezember? What do you think? December 6, 12 or 24? A quiz for you. Ein Quiz für Sie beide. Or for you all.
Choose one.
They're coming on December 6th. And they're bringing the presents for the kids. Am 6. bringen sie ihre Geschenke. And where do they put the presents? This is the next quest for you. They put the presents under a tree, in a boot, or in the bed. Ins Bett oder in einen Stiefel oder unter dem Baum. What do you think? In a boot or under the tree or in the bed?
Under the tree.
No, again. No, also not in the bed, in a boot. Yeah. Oh, you were right. They are putting the presents in a boot. So all the kids in Germany are putting one boot outside the door on the night of December 5th. And in the morning of December 6th, they can find the presents there. Am 6. Dezember finden sie ihre Geschenke. So in this story, the two guys cannot find the village, and they ask the animals in the forest, die beiden suchen das Dorf und fragen die Tiere im Wald. And when they finally arrive in the village, als sie im Dorf ankommen, they cannot find any kids. Finden sie keine Kinder. They're looking here and looking there. Sie suchen überall. And in the end, a cat tells them where the kids are hidden. Mm-hmm. Eine Katze sagt ihnen, wo die Kinder sind. And they find, finally, they find the kids who have a surprise for both of them. So they have prepared some presents for the two of them. Die Kinder haben ein Geschenk vorbereitet, sie haben sich versteckt, and they're all having a big party. Also alle feiern zusammen, and they're not so scared of Knecht Ruprecht. Mm-hmm. Sie haben keine Angst vor Knecht Ruprecht, who's really the scary friend. So usually he has a big bag, er hat immer einen großen Sack dabei, and the kids who have been good all year, they receive the presents, and the kids who have been naughty all year, they will put in the bag and take them away. Also die Kinder, die nicht gut waren in dem Jahr, die werden mitgenommen, und die Kinder, die gut waren in dem Jahr, die kriegen die Geschenke und die Schokolade. Yeah, that's it. And this is also nice to the touch. So this is on every page. This is a very a velvet touch. Sie können das einmal anfassen, Sie können sich das einmal angucken hier. Das ist auf jeder Seite, on every page. Du hast the left one. No.
One more minute.
Okay. So maybe we just leave this and you take this home. And the second book, what is interesting, it is written by Cornelia Funke. It's von Cornelia Funke. She's the most famous fantasy author in Germany. Sie ist die erfolgreichste fantasy Autorin in Deutschland. She's called the German J.K. Rowling. And in this book, a bad Santa is trying to capture the good Santa. Der gute Weihnachtsmann kämpft gegen den bösen Weihnachtsmann. In this version of the book, the illustrations are different from the Japanese version. Die Illustrationen sind anders. In the Japanese translation, the illustrations are made by the author herself. Yeah. Die hat die Autorin selbst gezeichnet. She's originally an illustrator. And while she was illustrating children's books, she was not happy with the plot, with the story. So she started writing herself. Also die Geschichte ist, dass sie eigentlich eine Illustratorin war, und dann war sie nicht zufrieden mit den Geschichten und hat selber angefangen zu schreiben. Okay. You can, if you like to read this book, you can also borrow it from my Kinkyushu. Wenn Sie das lesen möchten, können Sie das gerne einmal ausleihen. Und diese Geschichte. I'm running out of time. And this story has very nice illustrations too. I think the illustrator, Michael Sova, he's also famous in Japan. Er ist auch bekannt in Japan für seine schönen Bilder, der Zeichner von diesem Buch. Okay, that's all from me. Thank you very much. Danke schön.
Danke schön.
Super speedy. Danke schön.
Monica.
Yeah, I was maybe too long.
No. We started a little bit late, so but I didn't want to go over the finish time because of. Oh.
Sensei stole some.
I don't think I saw you steal anything.
It's on, so. It's on video.
Maybe. We'll send an investigator. Okay, let's continue. So next is Jose Camino from the Spanish department, and he will talk about some Spanish books.
Hola. So I'm going to talk, it's not a book, it's a magazine actually, and it's for kids. It's actually something I have at home that's for my kids. And it's the Especial Navidad. Navidad is the Spanish word for Christmas. And there's a number of stories. There's always like a story And there's, like, since it's a magazine, there's like recurrent other stories, like other characters and stuff. And I wanted to show you this one with La Familia Noé, if I can find it. La Familia Noé. Bien? Papa, mama, Mili, Jorge y Leonardo. Leonardo es un pato. ¿Sí? Bien.
Es pequeño.
Cuá, cuá. He hecho copias más grandes. Bien. Voy a hablar en español.
Está bien.
¿Sí? Bien. La historia se llama Queremos un árbol de Navidad. Esto es un árbol, ¿sí? De Navidad.
Okay.
¿Sí? Bien. Mili y Jorge quieren un árbol de Navidad. Bien. Pero es 1 de diciembre. ¿Sí? Y papá dice, espera, es 1 de diciembre. Bien. Entonces, en la sala Jorge y Mili quitan la página del calendario. Y dicen, ya estamos en diciembre. ¡Diciembre! ¡Queremos un árbol de Navidad! ¡Rápido! Y papá les contesta, todavía es pronto. ¿Sí? Es pronto, es 1 de diciembre. Pondremos el árbol la semana que viene. En 7 días. ¿Sí? Bien. Vale. Pero Mili y Jorge quieren el árbol ya. Entonces van al jardín y ven este árbol. Y deciden decorar este árbol. Entonces tienen la caja con los adornos de Navidad y ponen los adornos en el árbol. Leonardo, el pato, también pone los adornos. ¿Sí? Bien. Y terminan y dicen, nah, no está muy bonito. Pero viene una vecina es neighbor, ¿sí? Y la vecina dice, ¡ah, qué bonito! Esperad. Y la vecina trae una caja con adornos de Navidad, ¿bien? Y con los adornos de la vecina, el árbol queda muy bien. Después, otros vecinos, traen adornos. Y tienen el jardín, muy bonito, muy de Navidad. ¿Bien? Aquí está papá y mamá que dicen, ¿qué pasa? Miran por la ventana, ven al pato, Leonardo, Mili, Jorge y todos los vecinos. Entonces, no tienen un árbol de Navidad, tienen un jardín de Navidad. Gracias. Bien.
¿Preguntas?
¿Todo bien?
Thank you very much. Muchas gracias, José.
De nada, gracias.
It's a very nice story. Okay, and then we'll have one more story in Russian, maybe, from Grigory Mischenko.
Yes. May I start? Yes, so I think I'll try to speak in English as well. I will use some Russian, but I'm not sure if anyone can understand it. So actually, in Russian.
We can.
Yeah, choo-choo.
Hey, you can, yeah. So actually, in Russian context, it's when we speak about Christmas, we should first start with the date, because Christmas is not celebrated on December 25th in Russia, and there is a reason for it, because it's about calendars, Julian and Gregorian calendar. Actually, Russia, before 1918, Russia used old calendar. It's a Julian calendar, and after Russian Revolution, after the revolution, the country changed the calendar, but not the Russian Orthodox Church. And the difference between these two calendars in 20th and 21st century actually is 13 days. So that's why, because Christmas is a religious day, it is decided by the Orthodox Church. That's why it's on January the 7th, mm-hmm. and the Eve is on the 6th, because for the Church, it is still December, and the New Year comes on the 14th of January. That's one interesting thing, and another one is, of course, we don't have so many Christmas stories because of our communist past, I think. So it's religion wasn't really welcomed during the socialist period, so we do not have so many new stories written in the 20th century. That's why I'm going to introduce a story that is that was written in the 19th century by Russian famous writer Nikolai Gogol. He was born in Poltava region, which was called Malorossiya or Little Russia in those times. It was part of Russian Empire. Nowadays it's the territory of Ukraine. And after the upbringing in Ukraine, he moved to St. Petersburg, which was the main city, the capital city of that time. But he was known for his love to Ukrainian language. He didn't write in Ukrainian. It wasn't used in literature. At those times, he did write in Russian, but he loved Ukraine, and in his early works, Ukrainian folklore is represented very much, and so it is in this story, which is called "Ночь перед Рождеством." It's night before Christmas. Night before Christmas. It's not for small children, but it's, the text is, actually, there is two stories in this book. But first half is The Night Before Christmas, but it has illustrations. And it's very interesting, I think, even for preteen children, because something unusual happens here. Gogol was known for combining both realistic and magical events. So in this story, the devil steals the moon on the Christmas Eve. Actually, it was the last chance for him to do it, because Christmas is supposed to be the sacred day, so it will be impossible to do something like that after Christmas. But he wanted to take revenge on a witch, and one of the main characters is in this story is the witch's son, who is in love with a beautiful girl, but the devil decides to prevent him from meeting this girl, because he wants this revenge on his mother, and that's why he steals the moon. Because if it is dark during on the Christmas Eve, it will be impossible to find a way in the city. And all these events take place in a small village, which is supposed to be a Ukrainian village. But then the story continues actually in St. Petersburg, because the girl actually manages to meet this guy called Wakula. but she asked him to find slippers of a Russian empress who lives in St. Petersburg. So she said that if he manages, if he manages to do it, she will consider meeting with him. So he has to go to St. Petersburg, and because it's a magical story, he flies on a broom like a witch and so on. And the language here is very, very beautiful. I will read something. Последний день перед Рождеством прошел. Зимняя ясная ночь наступила. Глянули звезды. Месяц величаво поднялся на небо посвятить добрым людям и всему миру, чтобы всем было весело коледовать и славить Христа. It's about the first, the last night before Christmas, that it was a very nice day, and you could see some stars on the sky. But then it happens that all these stars disappear, and finally the moon disappears as well. So it's here. Три или четыре еще блестели. So three and four stars were still on the sky. Вдруг с противной стороны показалось другое пятнышко, увеличивалось, стало растягиваться, и уже было не пятнышко, близорукий. Хотя бы надел на нос вместо очков колеса с комиссаровой брички, тогда бы не распознал, что это такое. Спереди совершенно немец, узенький, it's called German, but it's not a German person, because everyone, for, every foreigner in Russian was called a German at that time. And so some German person appeared on the sky, and yes, it wasn't German actually, so there is a note that don't consider it to be literally German. And this person was actually a devil who was stealing the stars. He was stealing these stars, and finally he managed to steal the moon. So it's a very beautiful story, it's very interesting. And Gogol is famous for many works in his late works. So this one is, for instance, The Dead Souls. It's about serfs. Serfs are not slaves, but there are some peasants who were not free at those times, before they were freed in the middle of the 19th century. So look, before that, and some middle, some guy from middle class aristocracy tries to buy some dead souls, some peasants who already died, but they were still in some lists as if they were alive. Mm-hmm. So he tried to buy the slaves in order to make some I don't know, some financial schemes with them, and all the people who had these slaves were interested in that, because they had to pay taxes for those dead people, because only once in a decade the country calculated how many serfs or kind of aristocracy has. So it's an interesting story. And this one is illustrated by Marc Chagall. Marc Chagall is a famous painter of Russian or Jewish so actually he was born in Vitebsk, nowadays it's Belarus. It's close to Latvian and Lithuanian border, and so it was part of Russian Empire. But after the revolution, he moved to the West, and he spent most of his lifetime in France, and he died only in 1985, so 40 years ago. He had a long life, he lived 97, 98 years. Actually, his paintings are also known for its magical elements. So I think that Chagall is a painter whose style is close to Gogol's style in literature. So it's an interesting book, and both books I managed to find in our library, so it was in our library, and I also found a German translation, so Deutsche Übersetzung, Die Nase und der Revisor. Die Nase, that is the nose, it's another famous story, and the Revisor is some government inspector who comes, some person who says that he is an inspector, but actually he's not. So it's another interesting story in Gogol's style. It's not about Ukraine, and also it's about, because it's his late works, it's about life in St. Petersburg and in Russian big Russian big cities, yes. So I think it's that. That's all.
Okay. I have to ask, what happened to the moon? Did the people get the moon back?
Yeah. You should read the story.
Okay. Right. Well, thank you very much, everyone, for your presentations. Thank you, audience, for attending.
We appreciate
you very much. And if you have any questions, I'm sure everyone will be here for a few minutes. And we brought some cookies for you. If you'd like to help yourself, I'll open the tin. Please don't eat in the library. But thank you very much for coming.